fly.
I would say she's hit her head, but she always sounds like that. Dizzy.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And all that glitters is gold. Only shooting stars break the mold.
Star Ocean time. Right. First things first, get back on the Calnus and stand by for the big mission to save the universe. Where did I put the Calnus? Where did we park? It's always a nightmare, this, isn't it? Where is the Calnus? I could swear this is where we came in. Don't tell me I'm stumbling at the first hurdle. Where did I park the bloody ship? Ah, cheers. It's my own fault, that's my own stupid fault. Are you ready for a massive cutscene? No messing around, let's get straight on with it. The music certainly sounds very ominous, doesn't it? You can tell they're evil because they're black and red, and they've got the little monsters from the Matrix, the Sentinels. Falling asleep, look. It doesn't give a toss about what's going on.
Destination, Nox Obscuris.
We know, Edge.
Engage.
We had like a 40-minute cutscene in the last episode where he's just talking about Nox Obscuris. It would be quite exciting, but like everything else in Star Ocean, it's just kind of a bit drawn out, isn't it? It's a good job we've all got different coloured lasers as well, otherwise it'd be really confusing.
Damn it! We missed again? What's the problem?
I don't know, who's on the guns?
Not me.
Shut up and watch.
Amazing.
What are you doing? Hurry up and move it. We'll be surrounded again.
What? Oh, yeah. Would you, Muria?
Edge, that's your character summed up in a single sound.
What? Target, manual aiming? That's not just primitive. It's barbaric.
People rely far too much on your machines.
Harsh criticism.
You people rely far too much on your machines, he says, sat inside a spaceship, using a machine to destroy other machines.
Straight for Nox Obscuris.
Aramat, you have weapons control.
Yeah, I know I do. That's how I blew up those like seven ships just now.
Continue forward.
Everything Edge says is redundant, much like myself. What are we looking at now? What's this?
Now that we've broken through their defenses, resistance should be light.
Yeah. We're setting down on the planet's pole.
Wait. Mr. Edge, look at this.
Huh? What? What's that?
Our defenses are light, Alan. Load of bollocks.
Damn it! What are we supposed to do?
Now we're talking. Is this phase? Is this the return of phase? All the crap I've given him over the past 2 years, I'd be actually genuinely happy to see him.
Where did that attack come from?
Edge, look at this!
See what I mean? It's not necessary to cut back into the ship and have a little moment where they're wondering where the attack come from. We're already wondering that.
Mr. Edge, we are being hailed.
On screen.
Commander Kenny!
I suppose this is hardly the time for cheerful reunions.
Yeah, we're all long-ass speeches.
I'm glad we could make it, Mr. Maverick. Allow us to join your fight.
Wait a minute.
We Eldarians may not be able to offer much, but we'll do what we can. Our friendship with Earth is important to us.
Wasn't there like a conflict between Earthlings and the Eldarians? Didn't the Eldarians believe that humans blew up their sun because of... Has that been sorted out now?
Incidentally, I don't see young FaZe with you.
FaZe is helping an Eldarian refugee ship, sir.
Please, take care of it.
Are you not here? He's not here anymore. How can I take care of him? Bye.
Calnus, full speed! Engage!
Engage. Oh, I knew he'd get some kind of Star Trek reference in there. Should have said on screen though. Missed opportunity. Oh, hello. Full FMV. Oh my god. Right, now you know it's serious. Now you know it's near the end of the game. I'm just sort of sitting here pulling an impressed facial expression silently. Just being silently impressed with what's going on on screen. It's actually quite exciting. What is Nox Obscuris? I know we spent an hour explaining what it is a couple of episodes ago, but like, that's such a bizarre level of artifice. Someone built this thing. What is it? Where does it come from? I thought it was a naturally occurring process. Why am I trying to understand what's happening right now? This ridiculous. The gooey planet ball just turned into a space dragon. And then it's shot with a big laser. Like, that's what's happening. Who cares? Oh my god, it's gonna destroy Earth. There goes the moon. Oh, no way!
Are you entirely sure we're alright, sir?
Yeah, no problem.
Huh? Commander Kenny and the Eldarian fleet are gone. The moon base is practically deserted.
There's no one on here. If it got exploded, only us guys would die and no one would care.
Perhaps we should have
gone. Yeah, that's what's gonna happen, mate. Now shut up and let me eat my dinner.
Going to the ass end of the solar system isn't a part of my job description.
What is in your job description, mate? Oh, I'm so glad this guy's getting some comeuppance. Oh my god, get ready, mate. You can get Rufus Shinrid off the face of the planet. The face of the moon, should I say. Look, see it in the background. Oh, what's that?
Hey, this isn't even booked.
Yeah. That would be perfect. He was waving it. Oh my god, that's amazing. Oh my god, I did it! Fantastic. This meat isn't even cooked. Fantastic. Oh my god, that's amazing. My god. If the sole purpose of that character, their only reason to exist was so they could get destroyed in that moment, it was all worth it. Because that was one of the most annoying characters of all time. They even went out of their ways to say that that base was deserted, so you don't have to feel bad about it. It's just that fat idiot and his sycophants wiped off the face of the universe. God, that was amazing.
What's the status of our fleets?
Nearly 40% of the combined Earth and Morphous fleets have been destroyed.
Damn it! Don't just sit there, Edge. You want to get yourself killed? Full-powered engines!
That ship is all banged up, Kay.
I don't think those seatbelts will actually do anything. I think if they were, like, in a collision, they'd probably get decapitated by their own restraints.
To protect the Eldarian refugee fleet from the Phantoms.
Yo.
Yo, what's
Sorry,
up?
I was late. Edge.
Stop acting
Bro,
cool, Crow.
Are you okay?
What happened to you?
So many Eldarians died right before my eyes.
Well, that phase is the only one we care about.
You've done more for them than anyone could have asked. Everyone knows it. Even I know how much you've done.
Yeah, even I, and I was trying to kill you for like half the game.
Take it easy. You don't have to blame yourself.
Thanks, Amelia.
We're in a little squeeze here. Help us out.
You got it. That's why I came.
Excellent. With you and FaZe here, we'll be able...
FaZe! That's right, FaZe! His chair belongs to Maddie now. There's nothing left but the floor, Kay? But I guess I can lend him half of my seat if I have to.
I'm sorry.
Huh?
I'm so sorry.
I really don't remember FaZe dying at all. Like I said, I played this back on the Xbox 360 years ago.
What are you apologizing for?
I could have sworn FaZe came back to the party, but this is really confusing to me.
I...
could stop him. He left my ship saying he had to save his brethren.
Oh my god. Are we going to get to see, like, an emotion on anyone's face? There's nothing I could do. Are we going to get to see an emotion on any of these faces?
What happened
to him? Take a guess, Edge.
He watched the Eldarian ships getting shot down by the Phantoms, one after
the other. What happened to him? I went home and had some tea. I was being dramatic for literally no reason.
He's probably...
Phasis? No, that's impossible! Lim...
You and I both know that's not going to accomplish anything.
I mean, there's some kind of emotion on her face, but it's more like someone who's been told, it's like, no, you can't have any sweets today, and it was kind of a little bit pissed off.
We'll just have to break into Nox Obscuris by force! Bacchus, how long until that thing has enough energy for a third shot?
I cannot calculate with complete accuracy. It could come at any time.
Cheers, Bacchus. That's your one job.
Even so, we have to go. We're not making it to the core unless we get past that thing.
Best probably just stand around talking about it for another 20 minutes. Yep, nodding. More nodding. Someone else nodding? Yeah, more nodding. Yep, nodding. You? Yep, let's all have a nod. Very good.
I have a plan.
A plan? You have some way of getting rid of that thing?
What is that? It's like thinking about something before you do it?
So you just wait there and leave this to me.
That's a plan?
Crow! What are you thinking?
I'm gonna use the Aquila as an anchor, fire up the warp engines, and reverse the graviton flow. It'll rip a black hole right in the middle of that thing.
This is no time for stupid jokes, Crow! Wait there! We'll catch up to you!
Don't! If you're my friend, just be quiet and see me off.
Crow! Fine. Just do whatever you want.
Do whatever, I don't care.
Thank you, Edge. I know you won't let me down.
Leaving the universe to Edge Maverick.
Quiet.
In another game, this might be dramatic.
Ota.
Like, I barely know who this guy is.
Joe. Eddie. Hero. FaZe. Everyone. See ya. On the other side. Of the Star Ocean.
I'd like to see one of those videos, an astrophysicist reacts to Star Ocean, The Last Hope. What am I seeing here? They just said, well, it's gobbledygook, stop wasting my time. It's ridiculous. Anyway, great stuff. Alright, is everyone just going to be depressed for a minute before we can carry on? So just count it out, shall we? How many seconds of depression?
The annihilation of Nox Obscuris is the
not even one! I'm like, getting back to what we were doing!
The status of the Aquila is unknown.
The status of the Aquila is dust, mate.
Edge.
Anyone else?
Shields up, all directions! We'll storm Nox Obscuris through the breach in its pull!
Yeah.
EM shield down. We can't take any more.
Hang in there, Calnus.
I could make it sound like he's going to the toilet there. Stupid, wouldn't it? Don't tell me she could have done something useful from the start. Oh, I remember! This is a sweet callback! Remember in one of those stupid scenes? She was drawing all over the floor. And, they were trying to stop her. She was, like, drawing on the floor. Oh my god! She was actually doing something. How many times have we crash-landed this one ship? Someone say, we appear to have crashed. Go on, I dare you. Who's going to say it? Place your bets. Did we crash?
Is this heaven?
Well, that's not what I expected. It's even more stupid than I predicted, that Edge.
It's not.
What do you think that was, anyway?
What do you think what was? What
it
are you talking
was my
about?
Drawings.
Oh, right, right.
Your drawings?
Oh, we know! We don't have to explain the copy. We got it!
They're yeah. not scribbles. They're drawings.
Oh, go on, explain what just happened.
I'm going to take a guess, but could it be that Lim's drawings acted together in some very complicated
yeah.
way to project a barrier symbol around us?
Yeah, I know, because I saw it happen.
I can't believe they had such power.
Yeah, wow. Let's talk about
pretty
it some more.
Good, huh?
Yeah. Unbelievable. I'm always astonished by their stupidity. Even after 40 hours or whatever it's been.
Thank you for
I think I've got them pegged. I think I know what they're going to do. And they always find ways to surprise me with
and
the
you too, Lil,
depths of their stupidity.
You really saved us.
Thanks, Lil. There's no problem, Kay.
Mr. Edge, I've made contact with the
Lil,
A2.
You're not too upset about
they
FaZe being dead, are you?
No
who?
The plan.
No, who cares?
We install the transporter and usher in the reinforcements, right?
Yes. And then
we proceed to the final boss.
Yeah. The moment of truth. Let's do this, people! Time to breach Nox Obscuris' core!
Yeah. Alright. Does this look good, Bacchus? No. Do you know, it kind of looks like a transporter from Star Ocean 2. Yes, I see no problems. Preparations for transport on EN2 are already complete. You may now warp wherever you like in the game and complete side quests and stuff. Let's have a save and find out how long that cutscene went on for. Wow, that was like 35, 40 minutes of cutscene there just to get inside this thing. This really is the end of the game. Alright, let's have a look around then and see what we got. Oh, hello. You stuck behind the rocks. Surprise! I wasn't surprised seeing him coming. No, it makes literally zero difference. Whoa, what the hell, dude? Traditionally, when you reach the end of a JRPG, you gotta do a good bit of grinding to walk the final boss, unless you're really good at the game, which I'm not. So I guess grinding is the way for me. So, I'm gonna have a little wander around. Oh, question is, can I get back to the ship now that I've jumped down from this ledge? Or am I doomed? Am I kind of boned? Good question, Mark.
Come on, let's do this!
Let's do this like we always
do! Oh, I'm glad these monsters make an irritating noise. Frozen. Oh my god, I'm dead. Oh, I'm great. Could you sort that out, please? Sarah. Sarah, that's your job. Sarah. 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 Oh, I've learned, avoid these enemies. There's plenty of monsters out there, there's no need to fight the ones you don't like. Those guys are annoying, let's not fight them. This is how most Grandia games end, with you inside like a wiggly monster place. It doesn't make any sense with some recycled monsters. I'm not a big fan of all the invincibility frames that the enemies seem to get. You know when you knock them over, you can't damage them until they're fully stood up again.
It's not like
really
I was
draw
back,
stuff out.
Is this all they've
yeah,
got?
You could say, well, it'd be a bit unfair if you could hit them when they fall over. We'll just don't have them fall over then. I didn't put that animation in there. I didn't decide to make that stupid decision in the game, did I? Rush mode, yeah, what does that do? Get to the end of the game without really ever properly figuring out what stuff that means it's a useless gameplay mechanic. What the hell? Oh, is that how I travel up again? Is that how I get back to the ship? It is, isn't it? Through bubbles. I remember now. Fight with Jimmy. I reckon. What the hell is that? Oh, I don't feel like. Because the little ones are always a pain in the ass, aren't they? Don't feel like fighting that guy. Look at him. Look at that. Go on, let's find out exactly how long it is. No, let's not. Let's not. Not even for the sake of it. Exhausting. Right. Stand here where this bubble appears. Oh, yeah. Get in the bubble. Nice. Jump out of the bubble. No good. Why did the jump button appear? In the bubble. In the bubble, idiot. Do I get damaged if I stay in while it explodes? What have we got? Hot chocolate. Seems unlikely, doesn't it? Let's have a quick look around. Yeah. There's a box there. The box right there, yeah. Yeah, just looking around. Weird exploding alien mucus balls and this weird wibbly wobbly planet. That box there had two hot chocolates in it. And later I'm gonna drink them. Stop asking questions. Oh, look at the size of this place. It's 10 times bigger than I would have guessed. Do I push forward or do I go back? I'm feeling a little underleveled and a little underprepared. And this place is looking absolutely massive. I feel like what I want to do is go back to the ship and try some item creation and do a bit of grinding and a bit of shopping. But I'll do, I'll probably do that off camera because it's super boring. Right, where's the bubbles? No, don't target that guy. Keep targeting this guy. This guy. This guy. Target that guy. Yeah, that guy right. He's right in front of you right there. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Lock it. Nice. I would have been depressed if I didn't make it. Wait. Right. So now all I have to do is figure out which where the rest of the floating balls are that can take us back to the ship. Easy. Okay. Somewhere in here. There you go. That's our ticket back. So long, suckers. Oh, there's another one over there. Oh, there you go. Right, we're in it. Oh, it's right next to the ship as well. That's perfect. Beautiful. Let's get on board. See if we can have a chit chat with any of our characters. I've missed that. Maybe, oh, it'd be especially a shame if I missed the last chat without even realizing it. Well, here we are. Thank you for everything, Edge. You being there for me is the only reason I made it this far. Oh, she's got literally no belief in her own abilities whatsoever. Yo, what's happening? Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. Oh, here we go, I might have one more. Not at all, I have just completed my maintenance. Oh, is that why you're just standing there staring off into space? Was there something wrong? All operations are normal, I have no problems to speak of. Yeah. Good, I'm glad. We couldn't lose you too, Bacchus. You needn't worry, Mr. Edge. I am with you until the end. This is the end. Don't forget, you still have a wife waiting for you back home. I did forget. Why didn't we meet back as his wife in the end too? Was there some kind of scene, like an optional scene that I've missed? I mean, otherwise why even mention them? Please do not speak of her. Stop talking about my wife. I do not know why, but my emotion circuitry, becomes unstable. Wow, how much of a robot is this guy supposed to be? Do not speak of my wife, my emotion circuitry. That must be kind of hard, no? Not at all. I have lived with this body for a long time. I am well versed in its handling. Were you perhaps wondering about it, Mr. Edge? No, I've got no curiosity whatsoever regarding your body. Oh, no, I'm sorry. There is no need to apologize. I have never sought to hide it. Hide what? It was merely one of those accidents that happen so often during scientific experiments. As an element of my Morpher's duty, I once wandered the galaxy harvesting viruses for research. I became infected with one of those viruses following a minor accident, and my flesh began to petrify. Oh, is that the virus we saw it out? Petrify? Yeah, remember, we cured that, Bacchus. Shame for you, isn't it? The virus originated as the stone sickness from Rogue. During my research, it began to mutate. Wait a minute, did we cure it? What actually happened? We cured Raimi, didn't we? She was turned into stone. Oh, who cares? Who cares what happened to everyone else on that planet? Conventional remedies were useless against the strain I was infected with, nor could Morpher's technology halt its advance. I abandoned a biological body fast failing to petrification, transferred my brain into this one, and escaped the jaws of death. So that's why you seem to know so much about the stone sickness back on world. Wait a minute! What do you mean your emotion circuits then? That's your brain, isn't it? That's where everyone else's emotions are. In their brain. If you transferred your brain, then why do you have emotion circuits? Oh, I don't care. The Morphers have the ability to generate living tissue, but I insisted on keeping this cold steel body because I am a weirdo. I judged that a body built for battle would be more effective in my pursuit of the Grigori. Bacchus. That is my name. Yes, if we stop messing, if we stop the missing procedure, so do we stop the Grigori. I will have no more use for this body. What? I believe I will return to my original body. You've still got your original body knocking about somewhere. Living the life that remains to me in tranquility would not be such a bad thing. Very good. You mean for your wife? I am a man as cold as this steel body of mine. My thoughts and actions are based purely on logic. My god. I'd be very interested to find out what kind of woman Mary G. Beck is. She should have forgotten a man like me, but instead she has suffered many long years alone. You sound like a great guy, Bacchus. I only hope I will be able to reciprocate such devotion. I guess you really don't notice those things on your own. You've got plenty of heat yourself, Bacchus. Did you mean to say heart? He didn't, did he? He actually meant to say heat. Because that's what Bacchus is always going on about. He loves the heat of people. What did you say? Never mind, it's nothing. No, tell me what you said, you little prick. Oh wow, coming back to the ship did not automatically restore HP, so I'm going to take a nap. And wipe. Should I stand by my bed while the camera fades to black? Yes, you should do that. Wow, that fade is much slower than I remember. Wow, I love standing around while the camera fades to black. That makes me feel totally refreshed. Oh, hello. What are you doing here? Let's have a chit chat. Glasses, check. Clothes, check. Yes, check. You are wearing clothes. Ample sleep, check. All set then. I haven't forgotten everything. That's all you need in life, isn't it? Glasses, clothes, and a bit of a nap. Well done. Who's in here? Usually Raimi hangs around in this area. Now it's nobody. Alright, good. I'm glad of that. Having a drink? What are you doing? Huh? Sat about doing nothing. Oh good, proper scene, here we go.
So many of my comrades have died. I'm sure they each had something they wanted to protect. That's why they risked their lives. Just like my Lucien.
Oh yeah, I forgot about her backstory completely.
To be honest,
your husband, thanks for the reminder,
still
Edge.
Haven't gotten over his death. But now I finally know why Lucien did what he did. He risked his life for something he wanted to protect.
Iria.
I'm not going to die.
All Edge can do is plaintively say someone else's name. Do you notice that? When Bacchus told him a sad story, he just went, Bacchus.
Does that surprise
you?
Well, I suppose it might. Until now, I'd been completely neglecting my own life. I thought it wouldn't matter if I died, as long as I had my revenge.
Oh, mate, you need to play The Last of Us Part 2 and learn that revenge
friends.
Is bad.
Traveling with you,
take 50 hours to learn that revenge is bad.
Forward. Thank you. I owe you and your friends.
Miria,
bit of acting for mentioning.
You really are a strong, good woman.
Oh,
that means a lot coming from you, Edge. Really? No.
Once we've taken care of business, maybe I'll let you make me happy, hmm?
What?
Hey, if you
look at that smile.
I'm
yeah, wipe that smile off your face, Edge.
Never tell a woman things you don't really mean, boy.
I'm sorry! I was just getting back at you for teasing me all the time!
Ooh.
To be honest,
I don't mind saying it to a sitcom audience, like, ooh.
But I'm afraid you're still a million light years out of my league.
Wait a minute, how can you be almost tempted for a moment and be a million light years away?
Happiness by myself.
Oh, okay.
I just want you to make some lucky girl you care about happy, boy.
That's Raymond. They're supposed to be together, unless they're siblings. I can't quite remember what the story is.
Then I'll admit you're a boy no longer, alright? We're going to be happy, so let's both get out of this alive, no matter what.
Yeah, you got it. That's quite a nice scene, I quite enjoyed that. Does this guy have any scenes? Do I really want to talk to you? Are you asleep? I get the feeling Aramat's the kind of guy. I don't really think he'd put up with Edge. But the time has come, my brethren. I'll be with you soon, Manu Edger. How was it the sea miracle there? She's just blended into the background. What are you looking at? Your mouse run behind those boxes or something? What are we looking at? Let me just have a little something to eat before we head out. Okay then, that's what they're there for, eating. Come on, you could at least let me cut some slack before the final battle. What? Oh, you could at least cut me some slack. Yeah, wow. Read that all wrong. I quite like the little animations where she can smell the food. Just have some. That's what it's there for, to be eaten. Probably not coming back. Let me just have a little something. Yeah, go on. Alright, great stuff. Hello? Little, training the dog today. What's happening? Oh, nice! Yeah, getting the scene.
Shake hands, goodbye. Kay. Spin, Kay. Good job. Good boy. Good boy.
Remember when Faye stuck his head inside that thing?
I'm teaching my doggy tricks.
Tricks?
He's a good boy. He won't be mean to anyone. Maybe if he learns some tricks, Faze will understand too.
Faze is dead.
That way, no matter where I summon him, Faze won't get mad at me, Kay?
Oh no, she knows. Oh no. Oh no, I thought this cutscene was out of continuity, but it isn't. It's just really tragic. Oh.
No, you're right.
I'm actually getting upset. I don't believe it.
Bunch of tricks, and we'll show them.
I'm too invested in this stupid game.
Okay.
So I've been playing it for 2 years.
That'll teach him, won't it?
Yeah.
You'll have to
that'll
say
teach
sorry
him.
To me and my doggy, Kay.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Get choked up.
In that
this
case,
stupid
I'll
game.
Cerberus, shake hands.
Nice one.
Looks like this might take some time.
Yeah.
Do you know what? I normally rip this game to shreds, but there've been some genuinely nice moments in the past hour or so I've been playing this game. That was brilliant. Of course, that little rat dude from the Earth Defense Force or whatever getting toasted off the face of the moon. That was just an absolute fist pumping moment of glory.
What do we do? What do we do? What
oh,
the gosh darn heck is going on?
I was just praising this
Welch,
game.
Why don't you calm down a little?
And just how am I supposed to do that, pal? There's all kinds of crazy rumors flying around. We can't confirm them, and the USTA is in a total panic, okay?
Man, say USTA, not the Earth Defense Force.
The director's dead. Nobody can get in contact with Commander Kenny's fleet. And that's not all. Some weird celestial object is supposed to be headed for Earth, and nobody knows what the heck's going on. It's complete and utter madness.
Yeah, you're usually
no
some on top of things, aren't you?
I don't even have time to slack off.
Slack off? What do you actually do?
Well, you're right about that.
I come to Welch for item creation, but she doesn't do it. We do it. It
don't
relies
worry.
On the skills of my
Stay
party member. It's got nothing to do with Welch. All she does
You're
is just wave a wand around
this.
It's got a giant hand on the end of it. I don't understand what she's doing at all. She just stands
right.
next to the menu doing
yeah.
nothing.
Go on out there and reduce my workload, kid.
You can
what
count
work?
On
you
us.
Do anything. All she does is stand around and have an obnoxious voice. That's her job. Cheers, Welch. What was I saying? I think I was saying something nice about this game just before I started talking to Welch. Let's see if we can make a better weapon. Launch interface. Yes. Launching
oh,
interface.
A new recipe, huh?
Yeah, sacred spear, I want one.
You feeling frisky today? Fancy free?
Create items.
Me too.
Oh, where is it?
What you want?
Sorry. She was talking absolute bollocks there when I talked right over her. Required skill level 7. Own 3. Owned. Ah, we haven't got enough. Angel stone or a crystal skull. Alright, where do I get those things? Guess what? There's no way of knowing where you get those things, is there? Can I toggle display? Will it tell me? No. Here's how you find out where you get those things. You do a Google search and look it up on a giant table on Game FAQs somewhere. That's how you find out. I'm not a massive fan of all those kinds of things. But whatever. Right, I've enjoyed that. I enjoyed that quite dramatic cutscene. I enjoyed getting the chance to talk to all my crew members. But what I'm going to do now is save the game and stop it there. I've got a feel for this final dungeon. I believe it's final dungeon. Sure as hell hope it is. I think I'm going to grind for hours and hours and hours so that next time we can just finish it. I don't know. Like, don't hold me to this. This isn't a promise. And it seems like a weird promise to make, doesn't it? Like, I promise you this will be over soon. But I feel like this is the penultimate episode, and I think next time could be the final episode of Star Ocean. We might be saying goodbye, and by we, I mean me and my brother who watches these videos. Hey, I think this is the end of it. I guess we'll find out soon enough. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Say bye, Edge. Wave to the camera. Wave to the nice people. Say thank you for watching. Do something. I was hoping you'd have like an idle animation where he waves or does something, or just yawns. Doesn't do anything, does it? Bye, Edge, you big idiot. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Huh?